The clean energy transition will never happen. It can't be done. It will take too long. It will cost too much. You can't shift from one energy source to another. That would be impossible. But what if I told you we've done it before? I'm Jay Lipman. This is The Day Before Tomorrow, and today, the clean energy transition. The current energy crisis is front page news. This cost spike has revealed our vulnerability to a volatile energy market, heavily influenced by geopolitical events and an opportunistic fossil fuel industry. But the silver lining here is that this crisis could be an opportunity to accelerate the green energy transition. Residential power is a big emitter, accounting for about 14% of the UK's carbon emissions and about 20% of the United States emissions in 2020. This is in large part because the most common forms of heating today are literally just tiny little fossil fuel fires in our homes, right? Whether that's oil or gas powered furnaces or boilers. And we're doing that because we haven't yet made the mass transition to more sustainable ways of heating our homes. For example, and you know where I'm going here, heat pumps. I bloody love heat pumps. So efficient, so clean, so green.
Jay, you gotta pull it on the heat pumps.
Sorry. Back to the clean energy transition. It may feel daunting, but I want to stress that we have successfully done this in the past. And that's what I want to talk about today. The story of a rapid, efficient energy transition that we saw many years yonder, back in merry old England. Story time. The year is 1967. The United Kingdom finds itself awash in natural gas, having found it in the North Sea 2 years prior. And the government wanted to use that new fuel source to more efficiently heat the country's buildings, which at the time were largely heated by coal. So the government launched a 10-year national conversion program. The aim was to convert the nation's buildings from being heated by town gas, a mixture of oil and coal, to natural gas. This was an enormous undertaking, affecting approximately 20 million appliances, 650,000 commercial consumers, and 13.5 million buildings. And yet, the project was hailed as complete just 10 years later, in 1977. And it's worth noting that part of the effectiveness of the program was the subsidized scaling down of the coal industry. Parliament passed the Coal Industry Act in 1967, which included measures like payments for coal miners who had been laid off. So that was then, this is now. In fact, it's the day before tomorrow. Which begs the question, can we produce a similar transition to clean energy today that the UK did going from coal to gas over 50 years ago? I think the answer is maybe, yes. That's not to say there aren't challenges here. The UK's Climate Change Committee, the CCC, estimates that around 29 million homes will need converting to be net zero compatible, over twice the number of homes converted in the 1960s and 70s. The cost of converting those homes today is also quite a bit higher than it was back then. However, here in the United States, we've had some exciting recent legislation that could make a big impact on the price tag of that shift. The Inflation Reduction Act, which you know I love, offers $4.28 billion in rebates and credits to homeowners for updates that make heating and cooling their homes more energy efficient. Finally, this energy crisis is manifesting itself as a cost of living crisis. That's why people are so upset. Their energy bills just keep going up. But that's why an energy crisis can accelerate the green energy transition. People want a cheaper alternative. And the good news, we live in a time where those cheaper alternatives are also the climate-friendly ones. You see, consumers are recognizing that a green home can also save them some green. And with that recognition comes hope for a swift, efficient, clean energy transition. You know what that means.
What?
More heat pumps.
Should we get you a cold shower?
No.
Should we just end the video?
This has been The Day Before Tomorrow. Thank you for watching.